every minute, somewhere in the world, 10,000 containers touch land. Cranes are lifting them, trucks are lining up, all the data dashboards are going green. And for a moment, just a moment, everything looks like it's working. A perfectly choreographed global ballet. Look a little bit closer. Behind the noise of engines and spreadsheets lies a blind spot, so wide you can literally sail a cargo ship through it. Because while your containers move, your data doesn't. Between ship and shore, between customer and warehouse, the digital thread that connects your supply chain snaps. Sometimes for hours, sometimes for days. The result? Production lines are starved of parts that are already in the dock. Planners are chasing updates that exist, but not in their system. Customers are waiting, but not because goods are late, but because the information is. This is the illusion of flow. The ships are on time, the cranes are humming, yet the organization is still blind. In this episode, we're going to explore how the blindness begins, how data gets lost between ship and shore, and what it really takes to rebuild the digital thread that global trade depends on. The real breakdown doesn't happen at sea. It happens right here at the point of handover. The moment a container moves from one system to another, from one organization to the next, the digital thread begins to fray. Think about the chain of custody for a single shipment. A shipping line updates its manifest. A port terminal records the offload. Customs open a clearance file. A freight forwarder assigns the truck. A warehouse logs the arrival. And finally, your ERP system, maybe, gets told that the goods exist. That's six handoffs, six different systems. Six chances for the data to fall through the cracks. Each one speaks to a different dialect. Think about EDI, XML, API, PDF, Excel, email, none truly fluent in the language of flow. Somewhere between container number, ABCU123456, and goods received note, 4519, the context is lost. A typo, a delayed in upload, a field interface, a human shortcut, and a chain of information, it snaps. In a world that moves in minutes, the data still travels in batches. The ship may have docked 12 hours ago, but your ERP system will find out tomorrow morning when the overnight job finally runs. And that's what we call data latency, the invisible queue that no one sees, but everyone pays for. To give this some real grinding, here are three real-world examples of how messy this can be. In the US, major ports and rail yards become choked not only by physical congestion, but also by missing handoff events. You know, the whole system was not built for this. Freight delays hammer the US. The missing or lagging data compounded delay after delay. In Europe, for example, we can see regularly global shipping realignments, rerouting of vessels, changing trade flows. These can be triggered, you know, to absorb capacity around issues in ports like Spain or in Morocco. But these overloaded terminals do result in waits and backlogs. But more than that, crucially, the planning systems for many manufacturers, they never update their inbound arrival times in real time. Also consider that globally, more than 350 container ships capable of carrying nearly 2.4 million TEUs, 20-foot equivalents, were waiting off ports at one stage. Even if the physical ship sits, the data about the delay often doesn't reach downstream parties until much later. Ships waiting, terminals waiting, warehouse waiting. Data waits too. So what's the effect? Your inventory tracking shows good in transit, when in fact they're stalled at anchor. Your planners schedule production based on expected arrival that the system doesn't know is already delayed. Your customers get promised a delivery date while you're still waiting for the data that confirms the goods even left the port. In global supply chains, one missing event can mean tens of thousands of misaligned actions. This is the quiet chaos between ship and shore, the place where control is lost and reactivity begins. In the next section, we'll see what that chaos looks like in practice and why the consequences ripple much beyond the port gate.